I welcome Dr. Nebula, please.
Good evening. I just joined the Public Health Center as a consultant after the superannuation. I think that is more to the point than all the past chair. I want to talk about skin bank because organ donation seems to be the topic which everybody is aware of now. So I said, why don't I talk about something which Tamil Nadu has, which a government hospital has. Actually, all the other organs are cancer organs for the donator, but the skin now is the largest organ in the body. When it's harvested, it becomes a tissue. It's actually a tissue donation which you give. The skin bank was started in India in Mumbai by Sunil Keshwari. That is a private sector. He and his father started it. And subsequently, in Tamil Nadu, it was Ganga Hospital. They used to have a state-of-the-art skin bank. And they're doing quite well. In the government sector, we started one because we have a one unit with 70 bed unit. And Stanley has one. The dermatology department has a skin bank. So this is what we need when there's a burn patient, 100%, 70% burns. We wish we could get something like that. This was thought behind the organizing a skin bank. So what is the mission? Why do we need a skin? In a burn patient, when the patient's autograft is not available, the allograft taken from the parents or from the other siblings, and it's not available from the cadaver, maybe a brain dead person or a cadaver itself. Actually, 6 hours after death, we can harvest. So when we get this allograft, they say we give temporary relief. So the morbidity is reduced, the mortality is reduced, and goes a long way in managing these burn patients. So what is skin bank? It is a facility where we collect the skin from eligible donors and the processing by international protocol. There's a book available for the department. Everything has to be ticked before the skin can be used. And the skin, when it's stored at 48 degrees centigrade, it can be used in 5 to 6 years. And the skin bank has a protocol for retrieving, processing, storing, and then delivering the skin. It has to be harvested within 6 hours of brain death or a dead person. Just to go with any room, a catered square foot room is enough, but what we had in the KMC was closer to 200 square feet, a big area. And we need all this. These are a few of the equipment which we need. The refrigerator, a biosafety cabinet, which we and the microbiologist use. What it does is it has a laminar flow, so it reduces the infection. And a biological oxygen demand incubator that's used by microbiologists, an orbital shaker, centrifuge, and a walk-in refrigerator. So the procedure documentation is very important. So we have a computer and a printer because every entry and exit of the person is recorded. We have to know who entered the bank, who left the bank, and we have to know how much was collected, how much was dispersed, and the stock and identifying. Everything is done as per the protocol. Few of the equipment, the bag which we carry the equipment in, I'll come to that later, and the orbital shaker and the autoclave is our second picture, and I think it's not over. And the VRE incubator and the biosafety cabinet on the far end. That is the biosafety cabinet. So there's a small procedure where we have to start a skin bag. We have to have all these personals and the infrastructure ready and then apply to the DMS. And they will send a team of an anesthetist, of a surgeon, a dermatologist, and maybe a plastic surgeon to see what is available. And then give the, when, once they're not there, we get a permission from Tamil Nadu government. Here, the transplant or the transplant authority of Tamil Nadu have signed the MOU for KMC. And we get a certificate, something like this. This holds true for 5 years. And the person, any surgeon will do, anybody who can harvest a skin can go ahead and do this. We have microbiologists very important, but we have what would be 90% of the job here. Technicians, staff, and drivers, of course, to drive the ambulance to the place. Actually, the skin collection ticked. There are about 43 things which are kept, and it has to be ticked every time you go for the collection. And come back and again refill, but I just put something, some very few. It is very important. There are about 17 forms to be filled. And my all sterile gowns, gloves, and the streptomycin pencil. They have written the solution, all the solutions, everything, the skin graft and the glycerol solution, everything has to be sterile. This is the walk-in refrigeration where it's little 2 to 8 degrees centigrade, maintained throughout the day. It has a backup so that the percentage, the liquid doesn't come down, and the UV is noted every day, so that there's a personnel put separately for maintaining this fridge. So the skin recovery, the taking from the cadaver to it reaches the person who requires it, there are 3 phases. The phase 1, where you go and harvest the skin and then preserve it 3% glycerol. Phase 2, then shift it to 85% glycerol. And phase 3, process the whole skin. It takes about 6 weeks and then store it for use. So what are the criteria for it? Any person who is 18 years and above can do it. And though a person, when alive, we can give a requisition or we can give a consent for a skin donation, but once we are dead, the consent is to be given by the next of the kin. If any person from the family says no, we cannot harvest the skin, in spite of us giving the consent for donation of the skin after death. So very few contraindications. Actually, the 3 pages filled with contraindications. The main ones are, we do not know the time of death or the cause of death, we do not harvest. If there is sepsis, cause of death is sepsis, do not harvest. HIV, hepatitis B, is a contraindicated, and malignancy, restrict no. So procurement, in our case, the brain dead patient has certified that the coordinator informs us. Then as a team member, we will go, medical officer, a staff nurse, ambulance driver after that. And the skin bag is a very sterile zone. Just before leaving for the place, we go into the sterile. One person would go in, apron, mask, and everything should be worn. They go get the kit bag along with the ice box, the glycerol, the dermatomes, everything is taken by the first person and comes out. He has to make an entry into the list of a time of going in and collecting it. Skin harvesting is a main job done by us surgeons. So skin, we are the last ones to be called. You know, the first one, once the brain dead patient is brought into the theater, just like any other theater, the kidney, the pancreas, heart, lung, everything is harvested. The last organ to be harvested is the heart. So everybody will leave and then we take over for harvesting the skin. Most will take from the time and available for the trunk. And the sterile procedures, just like what we do in the theater when harvesting from a live person, we use the same technique here. We have to shave the area, clean with betadine, put in sterile sheets, and then harvest them. It is put in at 50% glycerol and this is streptomycin, and then brought in back to the fridge and kept it there overnight. Sometimes the call comes in early morning, late night. Whenever the call comes, the whole team has to be kept ready to go and harvest the skin. The next day, this is kind of put into 85% glycerol within a biosafety cabinet, so that the laminar flow keeps it sterile. Then optical shaking, so these are done by microbiologists, kept in the walk-in fridge for 21 days as an incubating period. And then what we do is, each skin which are always is measured, the edges which are not good are trimmed, and they are meshed. And the meshed portion which are trimmed and that is taken for the microbiological culture, put in for the containers, aerobic, anaerobic, everything is seen by the microbiologist. This is where we do the, within the biosafety cabinet, trimmed and meshed. Each skin which take, each strip is put into a separate container and marked. So that when we are giving or using, we can use container by container. For example, if I have a 50% burns, I will need 3 cadaver skins harvested to replace for 1 person. I will need an ice box for transferring the skin. So once the skin is taken off using, wash it well with certain glycerol. And coming to microbiology part, in the first part, after 6 weeks, if it comes positive, it goes back for another study for 6 weeks. So the first availability is within only after 6 weeks. So only after 3 negative ones, we can take it up for use. And if there are 3 positive ones, only after that it is discarded. We don't discard the skin that is seen. So utilized for the raw area, as seen here, in more traumatic conditions, like this lady. This child had a contracture of the leg. So for the anesthetic reason and for the function, it has to be released. But contracture cannot be released and grafted unless when there is the raw area. So what do we do? We use the auto for the neck after a year, and the leftover skin was used to cover the raw area over which the cadaver skin was put. As you see there, it forms a sandwich. So the raw area is covered temporarily till the upper nerve takes over, and then we can go in for a second stage of covering the body. So there are a few questions people keep on asking me. This cadaver skin is the only temporary cover. It is usually rejected by the patient. But the advantage is, till that period, the patient is free of pain. So general condition can be improved, and the patient can be made ready for to harvest his or her own. And immunosuppressants are not required because the skin is only a tissue which is harvested. So we do not have to give like as other organs. The patient does not get an immunosuppressant. So the team. So I think they will be going strong. I had died last year. So they are taking over the then it's injected. When the injection comes, it's outright. The whole skin will come.